The recent case of Oumuamua, the interstellar asteroid, underscores that our solar system is not by any means isolated from the rest of the galaxy. Rather, it is a member of a galactic system that exchanges electromagnetic waves and even comets and asteroids and even planets. Up until now, detecting these objects was difficult, but as instrumentation has improved, we're now able to see objects like Oumuamua as they pass through our system. And current estimates are that we're going to see a lot of this in the future, offering us plenty of opportunity to study the conditions of other star systems from the comfort of our own solar system. But as Oumuamua shows, that won't always be easy. It's traveling very fast through the solar system, and while it's not impossible that we might study it with a probe, it would be a difficult task. But in reality, it's not the only object of suspected interstellar origin in this solar system. Jupiter is large enough to capture these objects and put them into orbit around the Sun. This is thought to happen only occasionally, something on the order of once every 60 million years. But that's actually a lot in light that the solar system has been here for 4.5 billion years. There should be quite a few captured objects out there for us to study, and indeed, we already have two candidates. The first is Comet 96P Macholtz. First discovered in 1986, this comet has both an unusual orbit that brings the comet very close to the Sun, and a highly unusual composition in that it is both depleted in carbon and cyanogens. One possibility to explain this is that it formed in another star system, though it may have also formed in a particularly cold part of the early solar system, and repeated close passes to the Sun depleted the cyanogens. The second candidate is Comet Hyakutake, which made headlines in 1996 in that it was a really bright naked-eye comet for a short time. This comet was surrounded by all sorts of interesting space oddness. It was actually discovered by Yuji Hyakutake, a Japanese amateur astronomer who specifically searched for new comets. He found them, all right. He discovered this particular comet while looking for another comet Hyakutake he had discovered only a few weeks previous. And more recently, for his service to astronomy, they named an asteroid after him, which might be a record for having objects in space named after you. Another oddity, which wasn't noticed until years later, came from the Ulysses spacecraft, which recorded a series of strange magnetic and proton measurements in space, indicating that it had crossed the wake of an object. That turned out to be Comet Hyakutake. But this comet, too, was found to be anomalous chemically. It contained hydrocarbon ices such as methane, acetylene, and ethane. Current models of the composition of the original solar nebula suggest that while methane was abundant, ethane and acetylene were present at much lower levels. This should have been the case for this comet, but all three were abundant. Explanations for this could include that it is an interstellar object, or interstellar material was present in the early solar system and contributed to this comet's formation. The idea that comets from other solar systems can appear in our solar system is a captivating one. After all, how cool is it to get to study materials from another star system? But we have also found within our own comets and meteorites associated with them, the building blocks of life, amino acids, and life on Earth may have arose using materials delivered by comets. Who knows what studying the composition of interstellar comets might tell us about the prospects for life elsewhere in the universe. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, and if you would like to help support the channel, check out my Patreon page, link in the description below, or check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.